Hello YouTube. Right. Some people when they're processing video haven't got that much option over things like the bitrate settings and other stuff when they're generating their video to upload to YouTube. As a result, they're winding up with massive files that are causing them grief. I'll give you a rough guide now to the kind of output that I'm reaching here, so you can get an idea as to whether or not the rest of this video is going to be of interest to you. The output of roughly a 50-minute video at 1024x576, I've outputted that at about 555.5 megabytes. So we're talking roughly 100 meg per 10 minutes, or 10 meg a minute. That's roughly what the output is from this process. So if you're already achieving that, this video probably won't be much use to you. If you're not achieving that and you'd like to get somewhere near that, this video might be of use. Now, I do prattle on a bit in this video because I hadn't had my coffee before I started recording. I'm watching now, the bin men are coming up, so you might see some flashing lights. I've got to keep an eye on them because I've got to watch it. Yes, it's recycling, we're okay. Different bin collections, yada yada. If we put out the wrong bin, then we're stuffed for another fortnight. Where was I? Yeah, I do prattle on a bit because I'm literally winging this as I'm going. You probably want to watch the video in its entirety before you start acting on it. This is recorded on the 30th of December, but some systems are being updated quite quickly, so you don't want to hang around to get the right versions of the right files, or at least a section of files which will work together. That will become apparent a bit later on in the video. So, what's going on here? In Linux, we've had a system called FFmpeg. That's a very powerful system to recode videos and audio streams, but it's command line. There is a version of FFmpeg which is released for Windows, but if you're not familiar with the command line, you might have grief. So there is a nice front end called Avanti. So it's a case of downloading Avanti, downloading FFmpeg and putting them together in a way that works. For that we need a decryption tool, and there's also something else called AVI Synth that you can probably get hold of as well. That's detailed in there as well. It's not straightforward to put them together. There are templates, there are other settings, bits and pieces, all that sort of malarkey, which you don't really need to go into. You can just point it at it once you've got the thing working, which is a little bit of a faff, not too much. Once you've got it working, you can just point it at a source file, give it the name for a destination, adjust your bit rates, adjust your frame size, etc., your frame rates, and just hit the button and let it get on with it. Once you get used to it, it's as simple as that. And you can adjust bits and pieces to match, so it is a bit of a faff to get it working, but once you've got it working, it can have the potential to save you a lot of grief. So I'm yammering again because it's still early in the morning. This is morning sunshine, it's not even 9 o'clock, and I think I need another coffee. So I'm going to pass you over to the main griefer video, and I hope it's of help. Take care, YouTube. Bye. That was stupid. Bye. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to confirm to the stage that this is a re-recording. Coffee has been drunk. I am awake. So let's do this thing. I'm going to fire up a copy of Windows on this thing. I had a few bits of grief during the test phase. So I'm going to make sure that I'm going to re-record the video and hopefully make it less painful for you. Okay, in the hoo-ha bar, firstly I'm going to make an apology for the quality of recording on this. One of these days I will get a thank you for the suggestions of the hardware solutions to capture. One of these days I'll manage to get one, I swear. Honest, you're having to make do with, as usual, the camera pointing at the screen. There are going to be 5 links in the hoo-ha bar. Which will become obvious, because for the moment I'm going to keep this at a high-ish level. I'm going to cancel that. I'm going to make sure that I can see what's going on here. Can I see the e-drive? Oh, it's done it in two maps. Okay. Right. First thing you're going to need are four pieces of software. Now, I've downloaded these already, and they are the first four links in the thingy who's it what's it bar. One of them is the latest version of Avanti, which is this piece of software, and you want to download that. When you go, we're currently on 063, that's probably the one that you want to get. The next thing you want to do is go to zerono.com, this is the second link, and you want to download a copy of FMPEG for Windows. On this page, all the links are Windows. Now, most XP builds are out there are 32-bit, and you want the 32-bit static build. Now, it does appear that these builds are coming out all over the place, so you want the build which is from the 19th of December, which is 1D0AE92. It's currently third in the list. You probably want to get hold of that. Because I'm re-recording this video, you might want to grab hold of that before you do anything else. The next thing you're going to need is something called 7-zip. That's link number 3. From that, you probably want the 32-bit version, which is the EXE. There's a 64-bit, which is an MSI. You probably want the EXE version. If you're running a 64-bit version of XP, then you will probably know about it. What you do with Windows 7, I don't know, because, again, that will depend. The next thing you want is a copy of avisynth.org. You'll probably have to follow some links. You'll want the official build, which is up there, not the alpha stage, 32-bit. There are 64 bits under there, and 64-bit, you're on your own for that. You want the latest official release, not the alpha. That will then take you to SourceForge, and you'll have a link for the latest version there, so you can grab hold of the executable. Once you have them downloaded, you then need to go to your downloads, wherever you happen to have downloaded it. This is the download section. I'll get rid of some of the others, so it makes it a bit easier for you. We'll get rid of that, we'll get rid of that. We'll get rid of that and that. Whoops-a-daisy. So we will have effectively a few bits and pieces here. Now I'm going to switch this to let's see, tiles. Yeah, that'll do. And let's do a bit of zooming in. You'll have the 7-zip system here. See, that's an executable. You run that. That will install 7-zip on your machine. Just take the defaults, and away it should go. You will also have avisynth executable. Run that. Take all the defaults, and that should install nicely for you. When it comes to Avanti, you will probably note that it's a 7Z. It doesn't know what to do with it. Go into 7-zip and extract files. So that will extract the files to a folder for you, and you can see it here, Avanti 063. You'll want to do the same with FFmpeg. It's down here at the list. 7-zip, extract the files. And that will leave you with two files at the top. If I bring this down a bit further, Avanti 063 and Right, the first thing you want to do is grab hold of the Avanti folder and copy it. You then want to fire up a new My Computer, and you want to go into your C drive, into your program files, and you probably just want to right click and paste. Make sure that nothing turns blue, none of these folders turn blue, otherwise it'll paste it into that folder. And as you can see here, we have right down at the bottom an Avanti 063 folder. Let's bring that up a bit. Let's possibly zoom you out a touch as well, so this becomes easier to see. Oh, what the heck, I might as well arrange icons by name. Right, Avanti 063 is up here. So we're going to go into there, and we're going to go into the folder called FFmpeg. Now, I've already done this. So this is the C pro. You can see the location up here. where we are, because we've pasted the Avanti 063 folder in there. Now if I go back to the downloads and I go into the FFmpeg folder, in there is the static folder, and in there is a bin folder. That contains these three files. Copy them. Go back to your FFmpeg folder for Avanti and paste them in there. You can see that they're already here. That's pretty much the most of the file copying over and done with. Now, you'll want to go back up a level here and you can see the main executable, which is there. You right click on it and you want to send to and then desktop create shortcuts. I'm just going to move that and redo it for you. Send to desktop create shortcut, and that will create a shortcut to that on your desktop. Now I'll run over this again. We have taken the downloads, we have installed 7-zip, we have installed AVI Synth, we have unpacked Avanti using 7-zip, and we have also unpacked FFmpeg using 7-zip, which has resulted in these folders. We've copied the Avanti folder into the program files, into the C program files, and then we've gone into the folder and gone into the FFmpeg folder within that folder, and we've copied some files from the FFmpeg folder that we've unzipped, and we've copied those in there. So now we're pretty much good to go. Now you can start the Avanti system. It should say hello, and you're looking at the bottom to initialize the engine. It should say that everything's been successful and that there's a valid combo found for both FFmpeg and AVI Synth. Now, if you've done this, I did it wrong first, so I had to correct two things. I had to go into the options here, and I went into the user preferences. I had to tell the FFmpeg presets, use the browse, and I had to tell it where I'd moved it to, which in this case was C, Program Files, Avanti 063, FFmpeg, and then FF Presets within there, and then just click the OK. I'm not sure if you saw that, so I'll go through that again. It was a case of looking at the C drive, Program Files, Avanti 063, FFmpeg, click on FF Presets, and click OK. That then put the correct path in there. If you have anything in there, you might have to check it out as well. I will quickly zoom in for what happened. They should hopefully be right for AVI Synth, because that's where AVI Synth should actually install itself. That was pretty much all that I did in there. I'll exit without changes on this case. Oop, pardon me. The next thing you want is, you see this Start Process button down here. You might have to right click and say use other FFmpeg version, which is that option there. That will bring up the usual kind of thing, and you want to make sure that that is actually stored in the same location pretty much, which is your C drive, Program Files, Avanti 063, FFmpeg, and then you just double click on the FFmpeg exe and that should be happy. This is going through another reinitialization to make sure that it's happy. pardon me, and pretty much we've got a system there that's ready to rock. Now, where do you start? The first thing you do is you have a look at your source. In that case, it's you use the button here on the right hand side to select your source file. In this case, it's sc.org. That was my source. It does an initialization down here, and it shows you the source properties. So here you can see various things. We can see the current codec, Fiora. You can see the current resolution, which is 720x576. I'm going to have to adjust mine. I'll explain in a minute. It'll also tell us that we're at 25 frames per second. You can probably see that on the end. Now, if you've got a source which is more than that, you can probably bring it down to 25 frames a second in the options above. We also have the audio stream. It tells us that it's a Vorbis stream at 48,000 Hz stereo with 128 kilobit per second sample rate. This will affect what we do up in the top. Now, audio, dead simple. We probably want to use the MP3 codec. 128-bit rate will probably be the standard for this, but the sample frequency will be 44,100 with two channels. That's pretty much CD standard audio. Now, I want my audio to be nice, so I'll have it at 48,000, which matches the incoming stream. So that way we don't get any muffled malarkey when it attempts to downsample. The most important bit is over to the right here, and this is the video settings. I'll just zoom out a bit so you can see what's going on. Now, normally you will have things in here. Frame size might be source. Typically I leave that as default. I choose the MPEG-2 codec because that's pretty much a decent one that YouTube will accept. Frame size, source. Color space, source. I don't typically mess around with that. You might find that you're already on a frame size. I choose source for something that I'm going to show you in a second. Here you have the frame rate, and my source is 25 frames a second, so I don't need to adjust it. But if I wanted to save myself some frames, file size, I can deliberately knock it down to 25 frames per second. DAR, that's your ratio. Now, normally you'd have a ratio in here. I choose source for my particular situation. One of the big things that's up here is your bitrate. The default comes at about 700 and odd. You might want to have a mess around with that. I've chosen 1500. You can also enable two-pass encoding if you wish. Up to you. Now, you have to put a destination in there, by the way. I've chosen my destination. I put it in manually. An interesting one is whether it changes the... So what's going on here is because I've changed the codec, it's actually changed the extension as I changed the codec. That's handy. The long story short, with my... You'll notice that this is widescreen, which is actually... Where's my resolution? 1024 by 576, sorry. But you'll notice that the incoming is 720 by 576. That's because of a particular quirk with my camera. Although it's recording 720 pixels across, the ratio is actually widescreen. Does it show the ratio here? This is probably why this fails for me, because it's not taken the ratio into account. That's my mobile phone, very handy. So what I have to do, it would actually choose to render it in 720 by 576. It would compress it. It would take so many pixels per inch, and that would wind up with the wrong thing. So I've got to manually tell it what size I want, and that's under the video options, -S space 1024 by 576. If you click that, you will then go into audio options or video options, so you can change the various options. Now, you'll also notice that I have to put the frame, I have to at least put the ratio to source, otherwise it'll take this resolution and it'll muck it up for me. It will force it back to a 4:3 ratio, which is what that's in, when actually I want 16:9. I found that if I just take that to source and put manually the resolution that I want, I'm good to go. Now, you can use this to your own advantage, because if your recording medium is chucking out a ridiculous resolution, you can use this option to bring it down to something that's more manageable. If you've got a high quality video and you want to keep a high quality, you can sort of balance off the size and the bitrate. Say for example, I could reduce the size of the video. I'd have to watch my resolution, but up the bitrate. And that would still create a nice balance between video size and bitrate, because it's absolutely pointless putting up a ridiculously high resolution if people are only going to watch it on YouTube in a lower resolution. So if you happen to be recording in 1,200 and yada, or 1,800 and yada yada by something ridiculous, you can force the size down, you can up your bitrate, and you'll still result in a nice, reasonable, watchable video. Now, these figures are all down to you, and the balance is up to you to test and see what you're more comfortable with. And there you pretty much go. When you first hit start process on this, you'll probably find that you get a warning. Well, I haven't got one, because it does say, there is normally a standard warning that comes up at least once that says you can get better control over this by going into the user preferences. I haven't got along with that, I haven't found it yet. Destination already file already exists. I'm going to answer no to that, because we've already been through this process. I happen to know that this 50-minute video processed at that size at a bitrate of 1500 comes out at 555.5 meg. Good, innit? Right. Mess around. Go through the process. See what you get out as a result. And if you don't like it, you can change the size and bitrate to suit. Now, the third website that I'm going to bring up Firefox for here. Sorry, the fifth in the link is actually a link to the FFmpeg page. If you happen to get used to this kind of thing, then this page, I'm just going to zoom out, will give you all the options. I'm going to zoom in on the side. You probably want to have a read of this. You can see that the format, you put FFmpeg, minus I, your input file, any options that you want, and then your output file, and it picks up the format from the outputs extension that you put in. This is an example to set the video bitrate to 64 kilobits per second. Notice the K. To force the frame rate of the output file to 24 frames per second, that's the kind of option you'd put in between. To force it valid for raw formats only. There's an R, okay. To force the frame rate of the input file. So there's processing before the input file and processing during the process, and then you have the output. It's important where you put these options. You shouldn't have to mess around with that too much if you're staying within Avanti. However, all these options are available to you because you saw the minus S going in there. So you can use these options if you need to override stuff. Filters, logi level, minus F, minus Y, etc. Minus target, yada yada. Here's the important one, which is minus S for minus size. And you can either input, as you saw, width x height with a small x, width times height, or you can use one of these shorthands if you're used to them. This thing can go all the way up to a ridiculous size, which is this one here, WHUXGA, which is 7,680 by 4,800. You probably don't want to be doing that for uploading to YouTube. You have control over the aspect ratio, and you can use all these options in your processing. So most of these options are taken care of for basic processing within Avanti. The only one that we've put in here is the minus S for the size. So give it a shot, give it a trial, have a mess around with it. Remember that if you've already installed Avanti and had a mess around, that you will need to change the user preferences so that the FFmpeg presets are in the right place. And you will also have to right click on start processes and use other FFmpeg version and point it to the right FFmpeg. That is pretty much what you're going to have to do, and you should be okay and good to go. You don't have to mess around with any of the template stuff. So there we are, we have it there for you. If you have any questions about this, drop me a note in the comments, send me a PM, whatever you usually do, and we'll take it from there. But that should enable you to get up and running and process your video down to a smaller size for a suitable size for uploading to YouTube. Have a mess, have a play, see what you wind up with. Record about a 2 or 3 minute video first, however you normally process it. Put it through that and see what you see what comes out. And mess around with some of the settings, see what's acceptable to you. But there you have it. Catch you later, YouTube. Take care. Bye.